According to YouTube analytics, my viewers really want to know how to create a bootable USB drive. Noblesse oblige, as they say. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make the only bootable USB stick you will ever need. To make this bootable USB, we are going to use a very cool piece of free software called Ventoy. The beauty of Ventoy is that it allows us to create one bootable drive that can boot multiple ISO images, and adding images to the drive is as easy as dragging and dropping them. And it does not really matter which operating system you use, Ventoy can be installed from both Windows and Linux, which makes it very easy to make a bootable drive with Windows 10 or Windows 11, even if you are running Linux. The first step is to install the Ventoy bootloader onto the USB stick. Download the latest release of Ventoy from their GitHub page. You will find the link in the video description below. Ventoy supports both Windows and Linux, so make sure to select the version for your operating system. To install Ventoy under Windows, go to your downloads folder and unpack the file you just downloaded. Plug your flash drive into the computer and run the file called Ventoy2Disk. In the application, select your USB drive and press Install. After a couple of minutes, Ventoy will be installed on your USB drive. By default, Ventoy uses the MBR partitioning scheme, which should work both on older PCs that use BIOS and on newer PCs that use UEFI firmware. If you don't have any legacy PCs lying around, you should probably select a GPT option in the menu. Also, in the menu, you can enable or disable support for secure boot. I guess I should also mention that if you need to install the new version of the Ventoy bootloader without losing your ISO files, you can always do it by pressing the Update button in the Ventoy2Disk app. To install Ventoy under Linux, open your terminal emulator and navigate to the Downloads folder. Then extract the contents of the tar.jz file using tar. This should create a new directory containing all the Ventoy files. We will use a script called ventoy2disk.sh to install Ventoy. But before that, we need to identify the path to our USB drive. I typically use lsblk to do this. Type lsblk pipe grep sd and press enter. This should list all devices using the SCSI protocol, and this includes USB drives. In my case, the path to the USB drive I want to use is /dev/sdb. Now, to install Ventoy, type sudo /ventoy2disk.sh --i. If you want your bootable drive to support secure boot, add the -s option. And if you want Ventoy to partition the drive using the GPT partition scheme, add the -g option. Finally, add the path to your drive. In my case, it's /dev/sdb, and press Enter. Enter your password, and the script should partition your drive and install the Ventoy bootloader. After the installation, the USB drive should have two partitions. One partition contains the Ventoy bootloader, and the other partition is where we will place our bootable ISO images. By the way, the boot partition does not show up in Windows, so please don't be surprised if you see only one partition labeled Ventoy. At the moment, I have 5 ISO images on the data partition, and they should appear in the Ventoy menu if I boot my laptop from this USB stick. Let's test it. And as you can see, this is indeed the case. I can select any of my ISO images from the menu using the arrow keys on my keyboard, and then boot them by pressing the Enter key. And if I need to boot a different OS in the future, I can add more images to the bootable drive simply by copying them to the data partition. How cool is that? Thank you for watching, that's it for this video. If you find it helpful or interesting, please consider subscribing to my channel and pressing the thumbs up button. See you next time.